About 3,000 Italians died, 2,000 taken as prisoners of war, and, you know, 1,500 wounded.
And this is the Battle of Adwa.
Adwa, the Battle of Adwa. We are not in the battlefield, but just I'm telling you. Huh? It is on, from Axum, it is only 22 kilometers, actually. The Battle of Adwa is behind those mountains.
Wow.
So, the March 2nd was the 121 years anniversary of the victory of Adwa. It is a national holiday every year to commemorate, you know, the victory of Adwa.
Yeah, that's a real Black Power victory right there.
This is the ruined palace of Queen of Saba. She might have many palaces, but at least one of her palaces is this one. Not the only one, but at least one of her palace. As you can see, the queen was in the middle. Can you see the steps in the middle? That is a square building in the middle, 18 meter by 18 meter. That part, it might have two or maximum three-story building. So the queen was in the middle. It has a separate courtyard. And the rest compartments are for many purpose, for the storage, for the kitchen. For example, under that corrugated roof, there is an oven, maybe the kitchen. And then for the storage, for the prayer room, for the many, you know, rooms all around, about 52 in number. So, as I tried to mention earlier, she is very important for Ethiopian history. Her son Minlik, he brought the ark, and then he became a king later on. That's why until Emperor Haile Selassie, all the kings of Ethiopia were claiming as a descendant of Minlik and Queen of Saba. So Emperor Haile Selassie was the 225th king of the Solomonic clan. So as Minlik was the first and Haile Selassie was the last, the 225th. So that's why even Haile Selassie, when he was crowned, always a question was asked by girls chosen. So always, who are you from, what family and from what tribe? Always they were answering, I am the son of Minlik. I am the son of Sheba, was their answer, even those who crowned in the 18th century. Okay. So claiming as a descendant of Minlik and Saba. So this ruin was excavated in 1966. Before, it was like the ground behind us. It was like mound covered by stones. The reason why still there are many precious things left here is the ruin of many old palaces, not only Sheba, but this is, you know, the residence of the elite, you know, the upper class. Okay. So that's why the reason why it is a very rocky ground, it is the ruin of many old buildings. Okay. So that's why this is excavated in 1966, but there are much more still buried. Okay. They are waiting, maybe, for the future, many things will be discovered. So this is the mountain where the obelisk came from. This is the quarry. So we have seen, you know, the monuments of Axum, the stainless, hundreds of tons in weight. This is the place where they brought the stainless. You can imagine the distance, 5 kilometers to the field, to the stainless field. Maybe by rolling system, even to roll the stone, it seems easier than to carry the stone, but you need to bring thousands of people or elephant. You need to coordinate those people to work together. So it needs its own skill, you know, to carry such big, you know, pieces of stainless to transport from this place.
Were the elephants native or were they brought in from the south? Did the elephants live in this native?
Here, yes. There are many evidences. For example, one ambassador from the Roman Empire, he visited the Axumite King Caleb. Mm-hmm. He saw him when he was sitting in a chariot or cart drawn by 4 elephants. Mm. And this area was totally different. We are talking about 2,000 years back. Mm-hmm. This was dense forests with rain. Mm. So that's why there were elephants in this area.
How do you know that this was the palace of Queen Sheba? What evidence do you have?
This is a good question. What is the evidence? Yes, there is no any evidence. It tells us this is belong or Sheba's tools or material. But the potteries collected from underground, and they made the carbon date analysis and age it to the time of Saba. One, this is the main thing. But before this area was discovered, this area known as the palace of the Queen of Saba for generations, for thousands of years. The reason why they came to excavate in this area was because of the legend.
That's right.
What is this area? This is Inda Negeste Saba. Inda Negeste Saba, it is in Tigrinya. Inda is the place or the area of Saba. So that's why this area was known for many hundreds and thousands of years in the Saba, or the place of Saba. When they dug and excavate, and then they, that's why they say not that much difference, the things found from here and in the time of Saba.
And have these walls been rebuilt?
Rebuilt, especially this fence is rebuilt, totally reconstructed to protect the ruin.
Right.
But the more original part is the central part. Mm-hmm. The top 1 meter is reconstructed, but the rest 2 meter is original, the podium. The foundation is original, part of the, you know, the main building where Sheba was lived in. Okay, take pictures and then, yeah. Finish the picture from here and then we'll walk inside, okay? We'll sit in the middle part.
Now, didn't they also call her Magda or Makeda?
Yes, Makeda. Of course, I'm trying to make it very clear because of the time. But the mountain behind us is called Debre Makeda. Debre is mountain. Mountain Makeda. So the town of Axum was on the top of this mountain at the time of Makeda. Makeda was the bird's name of Saba. The name given by her parent was not Saba, it was Makeda. Makeda was the name, but during her throne, during her coronation, her throne name became Saba. Like Haile Selassie was Teferi, his coronation name is Haile Selassie. The same thing, she was Makeda and her throne name is Saba.
So this is the Makeda?
Makeda. Debre Makeda. Mountain Makeda is this one. So Axum was on the top, and there are many palaces expected on the top of this mountain.
Oh, so you think there's more? So these are the people here looking for artifacts?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Like coins.
Coins. You know, recently, people, they came to buy those precious stones. For 1 gram of this precious stone, which is being discovered from me, is about 15,000 birr. Precious done, you know, gold and something.
So